Hey there guys, today we are going to compare two of the latest flagship chipsets, that is to say, the Snapdragon 865 and MediaTek Dimensity 1000. Anyways, if you end up liking the video and want more such comparisons, then leave a comment below. Now let's get started with our video. Qualcomm has gone with TSMC this year using the improved 7nm N7P node, whereas MediaTek uses 7nm N7 node. The N7P is simply an optimization of N7 process. It uses the same design rules and is fully IP compatible with N7. Both the chipsets are octa-core and use ARM Cortex design. Qualcomm uses the same 1+3+4 design as last year and retains the same frequencies. 1 Cryo 585 Cortex A77 clocked at 2.85 GHz. This time we hoped to see 3 GHz, but that didn't happen. And 3 Cryo 585 Cortex A77 clocked at 2.4 GHz, and the rest of the low-powered 4 Cryo 585 Cortex A55 clocked at 1.8 GHz. The MediaTek Dimensity uses a dual cluster, that is 4+4 design, making it a little different than the competing flagship models. But the best part is, this chipset uses Cortex A77, which are not found even in some flagships like Kirin 990 and Exynos 990. The exact specification is 4 powerful Cortex A77 clocked at 2.6 GHz and 4 low powered Cortex A55 clocked at 2 GHz. The benchmark score shows Snapdragon is considerably more powerful in single core and very close in multi-core performance. The main reason for this is the semi-custom Cryo 585 cores. Qualcomm has bumped up their GPU to the Adreno 650, which is supposed to have a 25% performance improvement and is 35% more power efficient compared to Snapdragon 855 with Adreno 640 GPU. And if compared to Snapdragon 855 Plus, it's roughly 10% better. One new innovation made by Qualcomm is it will be releasing driver updates like Nvidia and AMD, making it the first company to do something like this in smartphone industry. The updates will optimize and fix bugs for newly launched games and make this chipset stand against the time. But it has a big flaw. The updates might get delayed, as we know how updates work with Android. The MediaTek Dimensity 1000 will make use of Mali G77 and features 9 cores, and the frequencies have not been revealed. It also has MediaTek Hyper Engine 2.0 for smooth gaming. There is no proper way to tell which one is better, and we don't even have any benchmark scores or tests, but based on past results and some new innovations, Qualcomm GPUs are always one step ahead of the competitors. So this round also goes to Qualcomm. The Qualcomm Snapdragon 865 touts a 5th generation AI engine featuring a new hexagon tensor accelerator. Qualcomm says the new chipset delivers 15 TOPS, that is 15 trillion operations per second, compared to Snapdragon 855's 7 TOPS. Qualcomm says the AI power can be put to good use, translating your speech into another language in real time while retaining your voice. MediaTek also employs its own 3rd generation neural processing unit, which it calls APU 3.0. They claim they have doubled the performance over its previous generation chipsets. Qualcomm hasn't been benchmarked yet, but we have the results of MediaTek and it tops the list. So you decide which processor would win this round. I will get to its 5G capabilities, but you have to wait some more. Now let's get on with display. Supported display for Snapdragon is 2160x3840 pixels, 4K at 60Hz refresh rate or Quad HD Plus at 144Hz refresh rate. And MediaTek supports for Full HD Plus 1080p panel at up to 120Hz and 2K Plus, that is 1440p panel at up to 90Hz. Qualcomm uses a hybrid memory controller supporting both LPDDR4X and LPDDR5 memory standards. LPDDR4X is supported up to 2133 MHz, while LPDDR5 memory is supported up to 2750 MHz, and the maximum RAM is 16 GB. MediaTek SoC supports 4-channel LPDDR4X memory with a maximum of up to 16 GB RAM. Qualcomm has made some impressive improvement with their imaging. The new Spectra 480 also claims power efficiency upgrades, being 35% more power efficient, and the Snapdragon 865 is an absolute beast on the paper when it comes to photography, supporting 200-megapixel cameras. The new SoC is able to record in 4K HDR while simultaneously capturing up to 64-megapixel still shots. It can even support 4K at 120 frames per second and 8K at 30 frames per second video recording. And you also have the option to record using the Dolby Vision HDR standard. Slow motion footage can be recorded at 960 frames per second, but unlike other chipsets, this can be recorded indefinitely. The MediaTek comes with a capable ISP that should compete with other flagships. They have announced the new SoC will support camera sensors with a resolution of up to 80 megapixel at 24 frames per second, or multi-camera setup with 32 plus 16 megapixel sensors. Media encoding capabilities fall at 4K at 60 frames per second. You guys have waited long enough, so now let's check their 5G capabilities and quickly wrap it up. Interestingly enough, Qualcomm opted not to integrate a 5G modem with the Snapdragon 865, instead using the X55 modem externally. Oddly, Qualcomm says it won't allow device makers to use the Snapdragon 865 in any device that lacks 5G. So Qualcomm is essentially forcing flagship phone makers to buy 5G modem and make the changeover in 2020. It is claimed the reason behind this is to make it easier for companies to design their phones around it. It can reach download speeds of up to 7.5 Gbps on 5G. It also supports both standalone and non-standalone 5G networks, as well as sub-6 and mmWave frequencies. There is Wi-Fi 6 on board along with Bluetooth 5.1 for wireless connections. As for MediaTek, MediaTek's Dimensity 1000 is the company's first 5G mobile SoC in its 5G family of chipsets. This chipset comes with an integrated modem. The Dimensity 1000 supports 5G two-tier carrier aggregation while boasting the throughput of 4.7 Gbps downlink and 2.5 Gbps uplink speeds over sub-6 GHz networks. It does not get mmWave. It also includes the latest Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5.1 standards for the fastest and more efficient wireless connectivity. So that's it guys, hope you enjoyed it. See you in the next one. Peace out.